Hey, what's up everybody? John from the Lucky Needle, and the shop is finally making some progress. So I'm gonna do an update video on this for you guys today. So stay tuned and I'll tell you all about what's been going on over the last year. Hey everybody, it's good to see you again. Sorry it's been so long since I've done any updates on this. I know a lot of you guys were following along, trying to learn from my experiences and my mistakes. Well, I apologize for taking so long to come out with another shop update video. I decided to stop filming them sometime, I think, around whenever the last one was put up, about a year and a half ago, just because I have ran into so many road bumps and people trying to rip me off, and just so frustrating dealing with contractors that the videos were just going to become multiple videos of me bitching and moaning and complaining, and I don't think anybody really wants to watch more than one of those videos. I wouldn't, so I didn't feel it was appropriate to be filming any of this. But don't worry, now that things are moving forward, I'm going to start filming more of these videos, and I'm going to tell you guys all about my mistakes and everything once the shop is finally finished and all the learning lessons that I have learned over this whole process. But anyways, long story short, the last video I filmed, I had told you guys that I found a company called Improved Metal Buildings, or whatever, I forget what the name of their company was. So basically their engineer took about 4+ months to get the drawings back so that I could go to the city and get it permitted. And, you know, he did finally in the end do a good job, but I mean, it's 4 walls and a roof. It probably took him all of like 3 hours to do the blueprints. So I don't understand why it took so long, but regardless, it got done. And in hindsight, I'll explain to you why I'm kind of glad that he took so long. So once I got the plans back and I took it down to the city and got everything approved so we could start building, called Improved, told them we were good to go. They sent out, you know, the contract, and they sent out, you know, I was supposed to send them $30,000 for the deposit. And I had happened to go on a work trip for like almost 2 months. I was gone and busy every day, you know, working 15 hours a day. And I just completely forgot to send the deposit in. And after I got home from that work trip, I checked my email, I didn't check my email. I got a notice in the mail, a letter that Improve had filed bankruptcy. So I really lucked out there. I was really sad to hear that, because I do believe they're a really good company. But if any of you, a lot of you guys are tradesmen, and a lot of you guys have probably started your own business, and one of the first lessons that you learn in business is just because you're really good at your craft does not mean you're going to be good at running a business. Those are two different skill sets that you need to learn, and I think that that may have been why that company, you know, failed, which is really sad, because their customer support was great. All the people were great. And I feel like if they had stayed in business, this building would have been done a year ago. So anyways, after that, I had to find a new contractor, and I found a new contractor, and then that contractor got in trouble with the IRS. So I found another one. They took the job, and then they decided they didn't want to do the job. I mean, I've been through probably 6 contractors by now on this whole job. One of them, I gave him $15,000 and he disappeared for 6 months and didn't answer his phone or anything. I had to pay for a background check. on him to find all his addresses, went knocking on doors, finally found some people that knew him, and then he started, you know, doing some work and actually starting to get it done. And I was fully ready and willing to work with him to finish this building, even though I didn't like him, I didn't like how he was treating me, and I didn't like, you know, that he disappeared for 6 months. So my plan was to work it out with him, but when he came here to start erecting all of the beams, he got really aggressive with me about more money. And I told him we'd have the discussion at the end of the day after all his guys left. And then he proceeded to get really angry, and he got like right up in my face, yelling and screaming, saying, "Look here, boy, this is how business is done in Alabama. You got to have money, blah, blah, blah." And I told James, I was like, "I will have this conversation with you after this is done. Today, I'm not gonna do it in front of your guys. This is unprofessional, like be professional." And I turned around and left. And because he had gotten so aggressive, you know, I was a little nervous. So I had to call some of my friends here, you know, to come out and back me up. I think we had like 4 or 5 people with me. And after he had shown that aggression, we decided that it was time to fire him. After he had gotten the poles up, he had done some of the form work for the slab, and he brought the trusses. So I felt that after that day, 15 grand with all the work and supplies that he brought, we were even. So we decided to fire him that day. But we were a little nervous because he had so many guys with him. And through talking to his guys, I had found out that he hadn't been paying his guys, and it was 2 weeks till Christmas. So they weren't very happy. So I just decided to do some cheap insurance to make sure that these guys were happy and had no animosity towards me. I stuck $200 in like 6 or 7 envelopes. At the end of the day, when they were done, walked up to all of them and I said, "Hey, this is the end of the line for James. He's not gonna be finishing this job. I'm firing him today, but I just want you guys to know that I appreciate your work. And I don't want any hard feelings between you and me, you guys to feel like you're owed anything from me for working on this property." Because, I mean, they know where I live. They know everything I have in the yard. So I didn't want any trouble. So for me, it was cheap insurance. So some of them were so thankful. They hugged me. They were super great. And then after I did that, I walked right up to James and I said, "You're done. Get out of here. I don't want to see you again." And he started getting all aggressive again, with like, "Oh, I'm gonna sue you and I'm gonna put a lien on your property and I've got way more than $15,000 into this job so far," which is a total lie. And before I could even answer, one of my friends, you know, fired back and was like, "If we have every single one of your addresses, if you do that, we will file a lien against all your properties, against your business. We will sue you for the loss of income, because the amount of money that I have probably lost in potential income for not having this shop built for over, you know, 2 years now is a lot of money." And I mean, it's just plain negligence to, you know, because I gave that guy 15 grand back in February, and it was 8 months till he really started doing any work, which, you know, was pretty scary, because I thought that I was going to lose that 15 grand, which you know, it's a lot of money to me. It takes me a while to save that. But, you know, some of these guys, I don't think they know or care. I think they just think I'm some, you know, rich kid from California with daddy's money, which is not the case. I sweat for every dollar I own, and I work hard for it. So I'm tired, sick and tired of feeling like people are always trying to pull one over on me. So anyways, back to getting the building built. So over the 2 years that I've been trying to get this building built, through Improved, I got connected with their concrete guy. His name's Jermaine Griffin. He's got a construction company called KJG Construction. And this man is the most honest, hardworking person I've ever met in my life. He is stuck by my side for 2 years, calls me every month, seeing what's going on, ready to work. And essentially, he offered to take over the job, and he would hire a contractor to finish the building because he really wanted to see it finished. So before I had fired James, he had already lined something up. So as soon as that day that I fired James, I called Jermaine, and he was excited that he got the job. And I drove out to give him a deposit check so he could, and he drove straight to the suppliers and ordered all the materials. And 2 days later, he was out here pouring the slab. I'll show you guys some pictures of getting the slab poured and everything. I'm gonna show you some time lapses of the video of the shop getting built. But 2 days later, they're out here pouring the slab. And I mean, they were here from 4:30 in the morning till 11 o'clock at night. So they were working hard. It was really, really impressive to watch the whole process. And then a week later, the contractor that he had hired came and started putting the building up. I'm gonna show you guys the building now, but I have a little bit of reservations about this contractor that did build the building. Basically, I can't complain about his work. He does do good work. If you can see here, I mean, the building looks awesome, but he was kind of shysty. He tried to cut corners a lot. I had to babysit him the whole time, make sure he did everything correctly. I hope it passes inspection, because there was some things that, you know, because the original contractor, James, who started building the building, did things, and then a new contractor came, and, you know, I think there's some stuff lost in translation, so not everything got done exactly perfectly. But anyways, I'll show you around the building here in a second, but he did a really good job. That was my problem was shoot, you know, he's pissing me off every day because he's borrowing my tools and asking for this and forgot to order this, and I'm having to drive to the store. So it was like pretty unprofessional in my opinion. Jermaine is not very happy with that, and he probably will not be using him again, but Jermaine is, he's a really stand-up guy, and he's doing right by me, and he's making sure that this job gets finished. you know, so he's awesome. I will recommend him to any of you who reach out to me if you guys are interested. But you know, it's just things like he left a bunch of razor blades in the dirt, and we have dogs. He stole all of the leftover hardware to the building before I realized that he had done that. You know, he cracked part of the driveway, so now we got to repair that with one of his. He cracked it with the crane that they were using to erect everything, and then also he quit before he finished the job. I think he didn't pay attention to the plans and quoted the job wrong, and he was blaming me and Jermaine for this, even though it was his responsibility to look at the plans and look at the order list and all of that. So he quit before he installed the doors and cut the man doors, which is a little irritating. I'll turn you guys around right now. Little irritating. I'm probably gonna go ahead and install these doors, these roll-up doors myself. I looked up how difficult that is. It's not too hard. And then Jermaine's cousin is gonna come and install the man doors, but I gotta go find those and pick them up. But I mean, you guys can see it looks great on the inside. You know, again, they did a really good job. That's why it's so difficult to be too irritated with him. I have a certain standard that I run my business with my customers, a professionalism standard, and borrowing tools or asking a customer to go to the store for you is absolutely unacceptable in my opinion. His name is Antonio, and he's based out of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. So if anybody comes across him, I would strongly suggest passing. But again, you know, I had been trying for 2 years to get somebody to come out here and build this damn thing. So at this point I was kind of desperate. So, right now I'm not totally sure what I'm going to do with, how I'm going to start laying everything out in this shop. I'm going to kind of start using it to see, you know, what I'm actually going to be doing and what I might need. I'm definitely going to put a car lift. I think eventually I'm going to put a mezzanine somewhere in here. And then I'm actually thinking about this lean-to here, because I have this whole storage lean-to here. So I'm thinking I'm going to actually enclose the back part of this, maybe like 20 feet or to this second pole or maybe in between, and then putting a door there, enclosing all this with insulation, and then making this my clean sewing room. That way I can, you know, air condition this small area. It'll be really nice. I'm super excited to have this building, you know, almost finished. It's been a really rough 2 years trying to get this thing built, because I ran out of money from buying the 10 acres next to us and then getting this shop going. I decided I needed to go back to work. So I took a lot of work and racing over the last 2 years. I've been on the road about 240, 250 days out of the year. So that's another reason why I've hardly been able to film any videos. But thankfully, so far, I have not had to borrow any money to build this shop. I worked my ass off over the last 2 years and saved up. It has gone over budget by quite a bit, so I'm like, I don't even have electricity in the building yet, and I'm running out of money, so it's time to get back to work and get things going. But yeah, you can see also, we had to bring a ton of dirt in. We didn't realize how much the property was going to slope. So I'll walk you guys over here and walk you around the building. But I want to say it was like, probably, I think it was 18, 16 truckloads of dirt. And then I just got two more this morning. Jermaine's going to come out today or tomorrow, and he's going to start grading this, making this all really nice. And then I'm going to have to put sod down here. That's our plan. We're going to put some topsoil and then some sod, because as you can see, the erosion is already getting really bad. So I cannot no matter what it costs, I have to fix this because otherwise the whole foundation is going to crack, and that's going to be a huge waste of the investment that I put into this building. Not 100% sure exactly what I'm going to, you know, start doing first inside this building. I do have one race team that is going to be hopefully renting it from me, so that'll get me some income right away, and then I'll you know, I'll be able to work from home when I'm working on their cars and stuff. But I'm hoping to get a lot more training course videos out. That's like my goal, a lot, you know, get some boat courses out. We think we want to do RVs, we want to do some other stuff, some more advanced stuff. And I'm tossing around the idea of doing some live training in-person seminars. So if any of you guys are interested in that, like, please, you know, let me know what kind of things you might like. Probably be a little while because I still got to get the shop set up. I still need to get electricity in there. But it's something that I'm entertaining. And then, yeah, I'm debating on whether or not to start the upholstery shop back up and be doing customer work. It's been kind of my mission to focus just on the training for you guys and building the Lucky Needle and the courses and all of that. So it's a difficult decision. I'll probably at the beginning do some customer work, but then maybe taper it off and just do enjoyable projects that I can film videos on. So hopefully this shop, you know, it's an investment in our future, and hopefully it's going to make us a lot of money over the course of the next few years, because now I finally have the space to actually do large projects. It's been 10 years about now with the Lucky Needle, and I've never had more than a two-car garage to work out of. So this is a big, big improvement. It sucks a little bit because I've got kind of a lot of animosity tied up into this building, just being so frustrated and, you know, almost getting screwed over so many times. So I'm ready to build some happy memories with this building, with you guys, with the business, with everything. It's going to take some time, but I'm going to love this building eventually. I know it. It's just right now, after everything that's happened, it's been super, super aggravating. So anyways, yeah, thank you guys for following me along. I'm going to do another update video today on just like my life, what's been going on the Lucky Needle side of things, and then some sawmill projects. You can see I got all that wood cut up there. I've done a few projects now with it. It's been really rewarding to, you know, cut down your own trees and build your own projects with it. So I'll show you guys some of that stuff. That's what's going on with the shop. I'm super happy to be finally moving forward with this and being able to film these videos again for you guys. So bear with me. Thanks for being patient. Thanks for still following. I will see you guys in the next video. All right. Thanks.